This week, the PCC Cup Series returns to its roots as it goes to the Death Bowl, in Southern Illinois, at the Grand Detour Speedway here in Quincy, Illinois. Note this week that Johnson Racing has pulled Ryan Jeffries from the 91 and has replaced him with John Jefferson after wrecking two of his teammates on pit road at Dwyer last week. This race is going to be quite interesting simply because we've got the very steep banking and the guardrails are not very, very structurally, they don't have great structural integrity, excuse me there. So we've had in the qualifier a few cars have flown over the guardrail, including Chester Benson in the number 30, so it's going to be interesting to see if that happens here in the race today. Cars have been warned to take it somewhat easy on the track, but since it's Grand Detour and the banking is variable in several places on the track, it's going to be interesting to see how the drivers cope with this situation. Your pole star for this week is the number 49 of Jacob Eichholz, and as he brings the field to the green flag, I believe this is his first pole of the season. You've got Daniel Lecklater on his outside, normally very strong in qualifying at these short tracks, but he did not grab the pole. But Ian Elias in third place gets a good jump on the inside, on the back stretch. It looks like he's gonna try and go low for the lead, but Jacob Eichholz holds the outside and will come around, and he will indeed lead lap one in that number 49 GoPro Katsev, doing an excellent job subbing for the injured Grigory Novikovsky. Here is the number 91 of John Jefferson, as I mentioned before. He is replacing Ryan Jeffries in this car for the week, and he said he was very thankful for the opportunity. He is currently running in fifth place here on lap number three. Here is John Kirkpatrick as he bails for the pit lane very early on. I believe this is only lap five, so it looks like he's got some trouble, maybe a puncture on that car. He brings that car into the pits. Here is Whitney Fuller in the number seven for Clayson Enterprises, and she's doing all she can in this car at this point. This is only her second start of the year. She's battling with the likes of Kelly Blackwater and Preston Bell there, back in about 35th place. She's trying to work her way up towards the front, but I do think that this team is coming back next year, possibly on a full-time basis, maybe with or without Fuller. I'm not sure at this point, but the team has indicated that they do want to return. As we go on board, Daniel Lecklater running in second place on lap 10 as he zooms right on by John Kirkpatrick, who appears to have gotten that puncture fixed, but definitely not the handling problems on that car, as he is still slow as molasses. Here is Barry Juvenile two laps later, and as you can see, John Kirkpatrick continues to hit the wall. Barry Juvenile is running in sixth place right now, having a very strong run, and he got around Ian Elias there. Those two have been going at it lately. They're what I'd call rivals. I mean, they've been taking shots at each other since the Cleveland Grand Prix last year, as now Jacob Eichholz is coming around to lap Greg Woodard in the 111 car. He's one of the slower cars this week on track. He managed to make it through the qualifier, but he is not quite up to speed with the rest of the cars. And now, looks like Jacob Eichholz is going to continue to extend his lead, starting to put lap traffic between him. Here is Tommy Urban as he runs in 10th place, trying to get around Isaac Michaels there in the 4. For ninth position, Isaac Michaels and Tommy Urban have both attempted quite a few of the American rounds here, and they're doing a pretty damn good job, both running in the top 10 right now. As you see, a couple other cars running up there. Here is Ben Worthington, who has needed a good run for a long time. He's currently running in the top 15, which is stellar for this team. He's really close to falling out of the top 30 in the owner's standings, which would be horrific for this team, because so far they've made every race, and if he drops out of the top 30, they're going to be struggling to qualify for these events, because this car has been lacking in speed, so a good run here would be a great day. Here is Mark Donovan. This is the fourth Retro 80 racing car, and actually all four Retro 80 racing cars As you can see, the two in the front there, there's Richard Dean MacGyver and Stringfellow Vincent, Mark Donovan and Pete Maverick. All four of them, are running from 17th to 20th place. Talk about equal equipment. They're doing all they can to work their way through the field. And they lapped, looks like they lapped another Lycoya there. That is Greg Woodard. He's falling a lap down, so looks like one of the Lycoya teams figured out what's going on here today. Here is, I believe this is Ingrid Hadeland in the number 23. She bought out this ride for this race, and at Dwyer, where she did some spectacular barrel rolling, if I do say so myself. She's currently running in 29th place. She claims to be a very good short track racer, but I think that the equipment is holding her back at this point. She's trying to hang on, as it looks like Jacob Eichholz is coming to lap her, and Greg Woodard is about to go two laps down here, as here, Preston Bell blows up from, I believe he was running in the top 25. As you see, yes, he just went a lap down there, but tough break for Preston Bell, as he is the first retirement from this race here. And now, you're second in points. Nicholas Corradovos is about to be lapped by his teammate, coming to lap 30 now. As you see, Jacob Eichholz is just setting a blistering pace. One half of this Griffith Motorsports team has figured out what's going on with their setup. The other half appears to be struggling a bit. Nicholas Corradovos in second in points, not doing so well, but I think Claire Aussier is doing a decent job here today. As now, here is Clara Crashall. She's running in third place, and she is rebounded in points. She was running not well at all, to be honest. Oh, it looks like somebody hit the wall there from that camera. But Clara Kindall has been on fire in the recent weeks. She's really figured out what's going on with her car and has been able to keep herself out of harm's way for the majority of the second half of the season here. As now Barry Juvenile, oh, he hooks Michael Grant and goes into the pits. Tough break for Stephens Racing, as all but, I believe, Chris Benson have suffered some kind of problem, as now Barry Juvenile is going to have to make an unscheduled pit stop here in this number 65 Jack Daniels Tenere. Tough break for him. As I mentioned before, here is Claire Aussier. She's worked her way up into fifth position, as now she goes to lap Barton Sandy. But what's probably a bigger surprise is Lenny Jacobs right behind her in the 52. That is her position, surprisingly enough. And it appears we've got a caution flag. Caution 1 on lap 38. John Kirkpatrick's slowness is causing some shenanigans for the leaves as Ike Durbin collides with, I believe that's Tommy Urban, and he goes flipping down the track and gets stuck in the guardrail. As now Tommy Urban gets going there, and oh, here comes Robert Nelson. Let's see what Robert Nelson saw as he hits Ike Durbin propped up on the wall, and he himself gets stuck on the wall, but his day is going to end. As we can just see, Robert Nelson is kind of chilling out on the guardrail there as everybody goes by waiting for a tow truck to come by. And here's what Tommy Urban saw going on board with him. And it looks like John Kirkpatrick just hit the wall, and he really just had nowhere to go but straight into Ike Durbin, seeing as Durbin was trying to recover that car. Here is Ike Durbin's on board, number three in the points, as he goes over and surprised that camera survived. As now we're gonna follow Jacob Eichholz as he takes the restart. Looks like Clara Kindall is going to make a move on Daniel Lechleiter there and try and go for the lead, but they're side by side going down into turn number three. Looks like Clara Kindall is going to get the edge, but coming to the line, I think it's going to be Jacob Eichholz, as caution two has flown here now right after the restart on lap 45. As now we're going to look at Tommy Urban, who's a bit slow, and oh, John Kirkpatrick once again, and John Kirkpatrick goes spinning, bringing out caution number two. Jacob Eichholz under caution brings his car down into the pits. I think this is indeed a scheduled stop, so this hands the lead to Clara Kindall in the number 14. Ramsey Cochiner has moved up into the second position. I think that's Ian Elias in third there. But now, Clara Kindall leads over Ramsey Cochiner. Clara Kindall, as I said before, this is a turnaround second half of the season for her, and I would not be surprised if she was contending for the championship at the end of the season. As now, as we look back, we've got some insanity back here. for the lower positions, as drivers are just going 3 and 4 wide now into turn 1 and 2, but they somehow sort it all out, keep it going. Johnson Racing teammates back there, I think there's some good team chemistry there, so if they were able to make that work out. And here is Jacob Eichholz, who's fallen back to pretty deep in the field, actually. Well, not so deep, but he's in 7th place. Deep considering he started on the pole and was leading the entire distance, so now he's going to have to work through some traffic, including Andy Lambert, last year's champion, is doing a surprising run right now. And here is Isaac Michaels, who's up to 5th place in this number 4 car. He's looked really strong this entire year, whenever he started, but his race never seems to go as well as he planned, as he always seems to end up getting wrecked in somebody else's business, ends up getting in somebody else's way. So it's good to see him up front in this number 4 car. And here is Claire Aussier, who I think pitted under that last restart, under that last caution, and she is back in 16th place. An uncharacteristically bad day for your points leader. She's trying to cut her way through traffic. It looks like she's trying to catch John Bracci there, but we're going to have caution 3 on lap number 62, as Isaac Michaels' day goes from great to bad right there, as Jacob Eichholz turns him, he gets in the way, and Richard Dean MacGyver makes contact with him in turn number 1, as Isaac Michaels' day ends right there. Richard Dean MacGyver takes a hard hit, and he gets airborne a bit. Oh! And we've got a pileup. Looks like Nicholas Cordovos is involved, couple others. Gonna go on board Lenny Jacobs and see what he saw. As yes, there's Lenny Jacobs definitely did get a piece of that. He drives away. I think he'll be fine. As now we're gonna look at what Richard Dean MacGyver saw. As he hits the wall and goes up a little bit, that's gonna take Cordovos out of the race. And looks like we might have a bit of a stack up back there. You see, cars aren't really filing through. As here comes Clara Kindall screaming through. She runs into the back of Greg Woodard and is gonna have a lot of front-end damage on that car as she tried to pick up the pace car. I think that's going to take her out of the race from the lead, as really not sure what she was thinking. As now Ramsey Cochener wins the battle off of pit road, seeing as he doesn't really have to worry about Clara Kindall anymore, since she really kind of brain fade her way out of the race, as Chris Winter blows up from, I think he was still on the lead lap. He was doing pretty well. I think he had a top 20 run going, as now Ramsey Cochener continues to lead here on the restart, bring the field around. I think that is, yes, that's Greg Maddox there in second position. Strong run for him today, as he's trying to work his way up in the points. Jacob Eichholz has worked his way up to third, based on green flag pits, or yellow flag pit stops, excuse me. Caution 4 on lap number 70, as we've got 4 wide John Bracci in the middle of this, and I don't think that's going to work out. He collides with Chris Benson, and Gaspar D'Souza turns him. He goes into the wall, and he's going to continue on. Not too much damage there on that 19 car. I think he's going to be fine for most of the race here on out, if he can stay out of trouble. Here is Ramsey Cochran, who continues to lead on the restart, bringing the field around. I think that, no, Greg Maddox is still in second place. Jacob Eichholz is in third, as now Ramsey Cochran brings the field around and continues to lead the field here today. Jacob Eichholz going for second place on Greg Maddox, and he will complete the pass here in turn number 2. And he's really working his way towards the front of the field now. This is by far the strongest he's looked all season. And now Mark Donovan has really had something going good for him in this Retro 80 racing car. I think they're running experimental parts in this car, but he is up to 6th place. A good run for the Retro 80 racing car that he didn't really get to see much. He debuted at Dwyer, but he crashed out on the first lap in that melee in turn 1. So it's good to see that he's doing well behind the wheel. And here are Andy Lambert and Ben Worthington, who are running in 8th and 9th place. Very strong runs for both of them in fairly underfunded rides, as really both of these drivers have not done as well as we had hoped this year. Andy Lambert especially, I believe he is still out of the top 30 in owner's points, and he has run out of champions provisionals, So he's going to try and work his way forward with some good runs like this. As now Jacob Eichholz has caught. Ramsey Cochner uses John Kirkpatrick as a pick, and he passes for the lead. Head into turn three here on lap number 82. But Jacob Eichholz is going to face some heavy resistance from Cochner as he battles back on the outside. Cochner not giving up, though, but Jacob Eichholz takes the bottom, and he will pull side-by-side again. But the variable banking here allows for the outside to prevail in turn 3 and 4. But I think that Jacob Eichholz is going to be able to clear him. Yes, he does. Jacob Eichholz takes the lead as I believe there was a caution. Yes, caution 5 on lap number 86. Let's see what happened back here. Oh, looks like a multi-car accident. I believe that is Ingrid Hadeland who got turned. And she gets slammed by Gaspar Souza. A couple other cars involved. I saw Kelly Blackwar, Lewis Jones, among others. I think Lewis Jones said something about how he was pretty fed up with how the 23 was driving him. 23 said she'd try and get revenge, and I think that kind of backfired on her here today. I think that's going to take the 23 out of the race. Jacob Eichholz leads the field down to the pit lane for pit stops under this yellow flag, but Cameron Taylor would stay out, and he would lead the field to the green flag on the restart, but for some reason the 32 is pulling to the bottom and letting Bobby Dollar by. Green flag is coming out here, and oh, 32 is dropping like a rock. What happened there, and where'd the field go? Where did the field go? Caution 6 would fly on lap number 90. As, the 32 car here decides to throw his brain out the window and stop in the middle of the racetrack. And as you can see here, oh, we're wrecking. Oh, that's a bunch of cars taken out. And he just stops in the middle of the track. And let's see what Whitney Fuller saw as she's going here on the bomb trying to get her out. And she doesn't break. There goes I believe that was John Bracci propped up on the hood of Claire Aussier, who in a rare moment of brain fade decided just to not use the brakes and just go balls deep and on the front stretch, as you see here. She didn't even bother using the brake pedal. Claire Aussier, the brake pedal is the one on the left, by the way. So you might want to use that. That's going to take you out of the race among a bunch of other cars. As after pit stops from that little schmozzle, looks like Tommy Urban is going to lead the field to the green flag after being involved in the first two cautions. Somehow his car is still fast and, well, on the lead lap. So he is going to go high. And it looks like Andy Lambert is going to go on the bottom and take the lead with a good push from Mark Donovan. Donovan moves up into the second position. And now it looks like Jacob Eichholz is going to drop all the way back to fifth place. As here's Andy Lambert with that awesome pass on the bottom around Jacob Eichholz. I think that's the only way that we're going to stop, that Eichholz is going to get stopped from leading this race. As now Andy Lambert in this underfunded number 34. This is the second time in two races that he's had the lead. Remember, he got the pole at Dwyer last week, so this team has definitely had a funding boost, as it looks like Mark Donovan is diving for the pit lane for some reason, but Andy Lambert continues to lead in this number 34 for ROG Motorsports. Not even sure if this team's returning next year. Mark Donovan and John Jefferson both dive into the pit lanes. Both of them are reporting punctures that they developed under that yellow flag. Tough break for them as now we go on the back bumper of Andy Lambert. As you can see just how fast Jacob Eichholz is closing in that number 49 car. Jacob Eichholz, a short track expert in that car. Subbing for Grigory Novakovsky, who is injured at New York Auto Ring, as here is Chris Benson, as he's doing a very, he's running very strong here today. I believe he is currently in about the top 5, top 10 right now, and he's really doing what he can. Here's Bobby Dollar, and he's currently running in 10th place. Very strong run for this underfunded operation, and he had a very strong run last week. I believe he was consistently running in the top 5, top 10 throughout the entire race before some fuel strategy did not play his way. As now we've got a battle for the lead here with Andy Lambert and Jacob Eichholz, who has definitely caught him in the last few laps, and he looks to the bottom, and I think he might use John Kirkpatrick as a pick here, entering turn number three. Yes, he does, and, well, there goes the lead to Jacob Eichholz once again, as John Kirkpatrick has some fighting spirit staying out there. He's definitely gaining a bunch of positions, but as you can see, he is quite slow, and a bunch of the leaders have been using him as picks to get around other cars. Caution 7 on lap 105 as Tommy Urban gets hooked by Stringfellow Vincent, and he slams into the pit lane on the inside wall. Fortunately, a bunch of the crew members were able to jump out of the way in time, and Stringfellow Vincent just kind of got into him and sent him down that way. So that's going to take Tommy Urban out of the race, I believe. Stringfellow Vincent will continue on without too much of an issue as Chris Benson wins the battle off of pit road under that caution. So he is going to lead the field to the green flag on this next restart, as there is Joe Craig. He's currently on, I think he's on the tail end of the lead lap at this point. And Ramsey Cochiner is all over the back bumper of the 55 car. It looks like Michael Grant is also up to third place now. Strong run for him. Jacob Eichholz is definitely trying to take advantage of that, and he goes around into third position, as now Ramsey Cochiner peeps low on Chris Benson there. And Jacob Eichholz has a very strong run. He's coming up there. So he is going to challenge now for, I believe, second and first, as it looks like Ramsey Cochiner kind of dips out of that battle. But now Jacob Eichholz is coming for the lead, as now I think we're going to have three wide for the lead there, but Eichholz wisely backs out, as no, he goes to the bottom now, and he does the crossover, and we've got three wide for the lead again in turn number one, and Jacob Eichholz does the crossover and takes the lead once again, as Chris Benson falls all the way back into third place, as here is John Kirkpatrick, who's still on track, surprisingly. He's 10 laps down right now, but he's in 22nd position, which is the most important part of this. This is a career run for John Kirkpatrick, the best run of his career, and he's still on track, just soldiering away, gathering vital experience for this car. He's not hitting the wall anymore. He's fixed the handling on that car, and he's really staying out of the way of the leaders. He's doing a very commendable job in that number 41 car. Rare praise from me for that number 41. Caution 8 on lap 120. As now Greg Woodard gets hooked by Mark Donovan, and he goes into the inside wall, and that's going to collect Bobby Dollar, who did not need that, and Lenny Jacobs as well, as Greg Woodard goes for a wild ride down the track, barrel rolling, and Ben Worthington nearly hits him there. That's going to take all four cars that were involved there out of the race, as Ben Worthington leads on the restart. He did not pit, but it looks like he just dropped a cylinder in that car, as he is going to drop back. Very tough break for him. He was running very strongly in the top 10 all race, top 15 up to this point, but he's still trying. I stand corrected. Lenny Jacobs did not fall out under that last caution, as you see him there, but Ben Worthington down to seven cylinders in that car, struggling to keep pace, but he's going to stay strong and stay on the track. Here is Andy Lambert as he battles for second place with Greg Maddox, who's had a strong run here today, and that's a very good battle. You've got Chris Benson in there, Greg Maddox, and Andy Lambert, all three of them very experienced short track racers, though Greg Maddox is also in the WSCC. Oh! Looks like Chris Benson made some contact there with Andy Lambert, but he is going to back off, and both of those drivers have a very good respect for each other, as now Ramsey Cochiner comes flying up, and he'll take third away now from Andy Lambert, as here is Jacob. Jacob Eichholz is in the lead, but Ramsey Cochiner is coming up. He is faster than the leader at this point. Here we are at lap number 138, and he's working his way towards Jacob Eichholz, definitely faster than the leader, and this is the first time all race that we've had somebody faster than Jacob Eichholz. So this is a surprising development here today, as Jacob Eichholz is being reeled in by Ramsey Cochiner from Ford Fast Racing. I think that's the name of the team. As here is Cameron Taylor, who's running in fifth place on lap number 141. He's seemingly come out of nowhere. He wasn't running too well at the beginning of the race, but now he's definitely stepped it up, and he's running in the top five right behind his teammate Greg Maddox in that number 78. Both of these cars are nearly identical in paint schemes, they just have different sponsors, but both of them are typically running nose to tail in these races, I've noticed. It always seems like Greg Maddox is outperforming Cameron Taylor, which may lead some to doubt Cameron Taylor's position as the number one driver at this team, but the team insists that they stay strong with keeping Cameron Taylor as their number one driver here at Winslow Motorsports. Here is Ramsey Cochner, who has caught up to the number 49 as they just put Ben Worthington a lap down in that number 6 car, who I mentioned before was down a cylinder, as he continues to reel him in. He's only about 3 car lengths behind at this point, and he is closing every lap, as you see here. He's just reeling him in slowly but surely. He conserved his equipment, where I think Jacob Eichholz really tried to dig down deep and pass for the lead on the restart. So I think that Ramsey Cochner is going to pass him here eventually, seeing as he kept his equipment fairly clean on the restart. As he starts to make a move there with John Kirkpatrick, as here is Cody Deke in the number 31 car. He's running in 10th place, despite how beat up that car looks, and his teammate Cale Bernhardt Jr. right behind him is in 11th. So a surprisingly strong day here for Johnson Motorsports. Despite being involved in a few incidents early on, they're still soldiering on here today. As here is Ramsey Cochner, he has definitely caught Jacob Eichholz. I think he's going to use, he might use Pete Maverick as a pick here, coming onto the front straight. He goes low, and he traps Jacob Eichholz behind Pete Maverick, and he takes the lead away from Jacob Eichholz on lap number 149. He takes the lead with just 50 laps to go, as now Chris Benson is running in third place here on lap number 162. He's doing all he can, and he has caught Jacob Eichholz, as Eichholz's car is uncharacteristically falling off during this run. He might not have a right set of tires on, as we saw the caution lights on there. So we're going to bunch him up again and send him off to go here. Caution number 9 on lap 163. Let's see what happened here. As John Kirkpatrick gets hooked by Cody Deke, and he goes into the pit wall. And that is going to end the day of John Kirkpatrick, who looked so strong early on. I think he managed to squeak a top 20 out of that deal, as Ramsey Cochner beats the rest of the field off the pit lane. He beats them off in the pit lane and will take the lead on this restart, I think. But here is Barry Juvenile, who blew up under the caution. He was running strong. I think he was still on the lead lap, running in a top 10 position at this point. Tough break for him. But another surprising development is Ramsey Cochner came off the pit lane, and he has suffered a puncture here with just one lap to go on the restart. He's going to follow the pace car into the pits and get that repaired. So that is going to hand the lead over to Chris Benson, who came off the pit lane in second place. I believe that is John Jefferson behind him. He is one lap down in ninth position. And there was also Ben Worthington there, who started third in line. He was a lap down at that point. So it looks like Chris Benson is going to have a cushion here for the final few laps of this race, as we've only got a few laps left. As you see here what I was saying about Ben Worthington, as he's still got 7 cylinders, and he jams up the whole back of the field. Only a few cars were able to get around him there on the restart. So Ben Worthington is proving to be an unlikely ally for Chris Benson, as he held up most of the lead lap cars behind him as he goes high and slowly lets them filter through. Here's John Jefferson, who is in 9th place, as I said before, one lap down, and he is having a very strong run. He's running with the leaders, as now Jacob Eichholz managed to get by, and he is going for the lead on the bottom there, but I don't think he'll be too successful. But Chris Benson fighting back on the outside. That car is very strong. He is a short track racer from the Las Vegas area. That's how he got the Stratosphere sponsor. But it looks like Jacob Eichholz is going to take the lead in that number 49 car quite easily, as Greg Maddox now is battling on the bottom, trying to get around Chris Benson for that position. And there's Andy Lambert as well. But caution 10 will fly on lap number 175. Final caution of the day, as Pete Maverick gets hooked by Lenny Jacobs, gets spun down into the inside and slams into the same place that he spun, or that his teammate Stringfellow Vincent spun Tommy Urban, but he will continue on, I believe, at this point. Here is Jacob Eichholz continuing to lead on the restart. Greg Maddux is right behind him on his bumper here coming through, but Jacob Eichholz just looks too strong for Maddux to get around at this point, as now Jacob Eichholz continues to build his lead over Maddux and Lambert. But Lambert here is going to try and get around Maddux for the position, and he is battling there on the bottom. Here we've just got 9 laps to go at this point. I keep saying at this point. I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen who are watching. Excuse me. But Andy Lambert passes on the bottom, and he will take the position from Greg Maddux with just 9 laps to go, as his car has seemingly come alive here at Grand Detour. He's going to try and chase down Jacob Eichholz in this number 34, a career run for Andy Lambert after he lost his ride at Aftershock Racing last year. But it appears that his suspension has failed him with just 3 laps to go from second place, as now he pulls into the pits, holds up Greg Maddux, and he will drop out of the race with just 3 laps to go. A heartbreak for Andy Lambert here at Grand Detour, but Jacob Eichholz will go unopposed coming through turn 3 and 4 on the final lap, and he will take the win at Grand Detour. Greg Maddux and Cameron Taylor finish a very strong 2-3 for Winsalot Motorsports. Lenny Jacobs, despite being involved in that one accident and he lost his hood, he finishes in 4th place. Chris Benson rounds out those on the lead lap in 5th place, a strong run for the rookie. Michael Grant finishes a strong 6th place for Australian Motorsports. Ramsey Cockener falls back to 7th after that puncture under the last caution. John Jefferson finishes in 8th, 2 laps down. Cody Deek finishes 9th. And Cale Bernfart Jr. in the number 51 Super Speedway Ace rounds out the top 10, 3 laps down, meaning an 8-9-10 finish for Johnson Motorsports. And if I'm not mistaken, I think Sam Brown finished in 13th, last car running, 3 laps down. Unfortunately, it was not an 8-9-10-11 for Johnson Motorsports.